Okay, dear students, so today our topic is that what is mean by translators, and also we will discuss different types of translators. Question can come that what is translators, and also discuss its different types. So first question arises that why there is need of translators. So a program written in high level language is called a source code. When we are writing any program in high level language means in any programming language, so that is called source code. I am typing program in PHP, in GW Basic, in any language that is except machine language, that is called high level language. So that program is called source code. To convert the source code into machine code, for that purpose translator are needed. So when we want to get the output from that source code, so that source code will be translated into machine language, and we know that machine language is a computer language that is in the form of binary language, in the form of zeros and ones. So after the translation, it will be converted into machine code, and after that we will get the result, we will get the output. So for this purpose, translators are needed. Now what is the task of translator? A translator takes a program written in source language. Source language means here source code as input. So translate will take it as input, and after that it will converts, it will translate, it will change it into target language as output. It also detects and reports the error during translation. Second task of translator is that it can detect the errors inside the program, inside the code, and report that error or those errors. What are the roles of translator? Translating the high level language program into an equivalent machine language program. That is the first role of translator. It will translate high level language, that language in which language we are typing any program. So it will take it as an input, and after that it will convert it into machine language program. Providing diagnostic message whenever the programmer violates specification of the high level language program. The second rule is that it provides diagnostic messages to the users. Diagnostic messages here means that it will show when there is some errors in the program after debugging. So when there are some errors or any other violation of the specification of the program, violation of the specification of the program means that when user does not type program format, for example he is leaving semicolon, double quotes, single quotes, or any mistake, so that is called program violates specification. So translator will give us message about that you are doing mistake in this line or in this program, or it is a bad command, it is a bad format, you need to put semicolon, double quotes, variable, etc. So these are the roles of translator. Now how many types of translator There are basically three types of translator. Number one is called compiler. Second one is called interpreters. And third one is called assembler. So there are three types of translator. Number one is called compiler. So compiler is a translator which is used to convert program in high level language to low level language. The basic purpose of compiler is that it can translate or convert program which is written in high level language into low level language. You are typing any program in any language that is called high level language, that will be except machine language, that will be converted into low level language, yani machine language, computer language, binary language. It translates the entire program. Compiler translates the entire program. Entire program means whole program, complete program. For example, we have typed one program that contains 10 lines. So the compiler will translate those 10 lines at the same time, not only line by line, but the whole program will be translated at the same time. And after that, it will report the errors in source program encountered during the translation. When there are some errors, so it will report us that in this line or these are the errors, please remove the errors. This one is the diagram for compiler, that compiler can take the source program and after that it will translate it into target program. And when the error will occur, so it will give us the error message. This one is the basic diagram for the compiler scenario. Second type is interpreter. Interpreter is a translator which is used to convert program in high level language into low level language. And interpreter is also used for the same purpose, that it will translate, it will convert any program that is written in high level language into machine language, into computer language. But the difference is that between compiler and interpreter, that compiler translate the whole program at once, but interpreter will translate line by line. For example, we have typed one program that contains 10 lines. So interpreter will translate first line. If there is no error, if there is no mistake in that first line, so it will move to second line. So second line will be translated. If there is an error, so it will report the error. It will report the error. After that, when we remove the error, so it will be translated. And after that, when there will be no error, so third line will be translated. So interpreter translate line by line and reports the error once it encountered during the translation process. When there is some error, so it will give us message that in this line there is an error, please remove the error. So after removing the error, so it will jump to the next line. So the main difference between compiler and interpreter is that compiler translate the whole program at once, complete program at once, but interpreter translate line by line. It directly executes the operation specified in the source program when the input is given by the user. When the user is giving input, so it will be directly executed. Source program will be directly executed and operation will be done on source program. It gives better errors diagnostic than a compiler. Regarding errors result, so it is good than, or it is better than interpreter, because it translates line by line, and when there is an error in one line, so there it will not go further. It will show us the error, that in this line there is an error. After removing the error, you may go to the next line. So source program in the diagram. source program you will give as an input to interpreter. After that, it will translate line by line, and after that, it will give us output result. Third type of SM translator is assembler. Assembler is also a translator, which is used to translate the assembly language code into machine language code. Then assembler is specified for assembly language. And as we know that assembly language use mnemonics. So for that purpose, for mnemonics translation, assembler is used. So assembler will translate assembly language into computer language. So in the diagram, it is shown that we will provide assembly language code to assembler. After that, assembler will translate into computer language. And that will be our output. Now, one question arises that what are the differences between compiler and interpreter? This will also come. It is an important question. So first you will write like serial number, after that compiler, after that interpreter. You will give these three headings. Now, number one, compiler performs the translation of a program as a whole. The whole program will be translated at the same time. That is the work of compiler, but interpreter perform statement by statement translation. Statement by statement translation means interpreter will translate line by line. Second difference is that compiler executes faster. Execution is faster. Yani its speed is high because it translates the whole program at once. So its speed is high, it will take minimum time for translation. But interpreter execution is slower. Why? Because it translates line by line. So it will take much time than a compiler. Third difference is that requires more memory as linking and needed for the generated intermediate of object code. It needs a memory. For what purpose the memory is needed? Because after translation, it will generate an intermediate object code. Now, what is mean by object code? When the source program is translated into machine language, so an object code is produced. So there is need of memory. But compiler needs more memory for object code. Interpreter, memory usage is efficient as no intermediate object code is generated. But in interpreter, no object code will be produced, so no need of memory. Number four, debugging is hard as the error messages are generated after scanning the entire programs only. When we compile any program, so the whole program will be translated. So there, for example, there are some errors. So it is hard to detect the errors, that in which line the errors encountered. But in interpreter, when the first error is arised, so there will be error message come to us. So debugging is easy. Debugging means yani error removing, error finding, errors eliminating, that is easy because it can translate line by line. It will show and it will show us the message, it will send us the message that in this error there is an error. But in compiler, the whole program is translated as you know. And there will be, for example, if there are some errors, so it is hard to debug the errors in compiler. Fifth difference is that programming language like C, C++ uses compiler. C language, C++ language, these languages uses compilers. Programming language like Python, Basic, or GW Basic, and Ruby uses interpreters. I guess you know that GW Basic we are using for practicals. So basic language used interpreter. So these are the main differences between compiler and interpreter. So from this topic, two questions can come that what is translator, also experience types, and the second question can come that what are the differences between compiler and interpreter. Now if you have any question, you may ask.